Let's talk about the Inbetween Assist, a new feature available on the iPad version of Callipeg. First, a quick reminder of what is Out of Pegs, the classic feature available on Callipeg on iPad and Android tablets. Let's say I want to do an Inbetween here. I have a few possibilities. I can tap here to add a new sheet. I can select and tap here on Duplicate Without Content to create a new sheet with the same length. Or I can also split from bottom to up like this to create a new empty sheet. So here I can activate my onion skin. I can enable, disable a few images before and after. So in this situation, to make an in-between from here and here, I will take only the one before, then tap here to enable out of pegs, tap here, edit out of pegs, and now I can edit like this and start drawing my in-between. So here I make it really quickly so I can follow the previous drawing to make an ease out here, for example. At any point, I can disable the out of pegs to see the initial location, scale, rotation of my onion skin, and I can enable it again. That's the classic out of pegs feature. But now in Callipeg on iPad, we are introducing the in-between assist. I will make a very simple example first, and then I will show you how it works in a more complex character. So let's say I have a sphere like that, that I want to make move. To make a second drawing, I can go here, create a new one, activate my out of pegs, enable it here, slide, validate, and start to draw my second key pose. So here, that's a very simple movement. And if I want to make an in-between here, I can, for example, here select and tap in-between or the other solutions I showed earlier. And I want to make an in-between between this and this. But for now, it's at the same place because I have out of pegs enabled. So I will just go here and reset. So I can see the original location of my onion skin. The in-between assist is here with this new icon. So tap on it. You can decide to select or unselect any onion skin. Onion skin already enabled. So if you want to enable more onion skins, you have to go back here. And let's say I make another sheet here. I tap here. So if I go now to the in-between assist, I can enable that. And I have a line explaining that there is no drawing here. So I go back to the previous state. I go to the in-between assist. And I have a few settings here. 1 point assist, 2 points assist, and the edit mode. So I can enable or disable it. For now, I will not enable it. I select a point minus one. So here you can see the opacity is full. So you can see what drawing you need to add a point on. So I tap here, I tap here, and I tap a destination point. So where do I want my in-between to go? It can be linear like that, or maybe I want to make an arc like this. So I will say this, and it will take my two onion skins, put them together. So now I can start drawing from here. And I will draw in between the lines to make an in-between. Let's see how it works with 2 points. So here I will reset all. I will also make it a bit more complex by transforming this and making it smaller. So now I want to go from that to that. I go to the in-between assist, 2 points. I tap here and here, and I try to be at the same place on the other one. Destination would be, for example, here and here. And now if I go to my timeline and I disable the scrubbing, disable the onion skin, I can see here what movement it will make. And I can draw like this, my in-between. That's basically the quick way to use in-between assist, but you can go to edit mode to have more options. So I will delete that. I will reset my out of pegs. Now I activate in-between assist. I go to 1 point again, but I enable edit mode. So I tap here and here, and then automatically it will decide where to put my in-between. So here you can see it's on 3/4, but I can slide like that to put it anywhere. With the snap here, it will snap on 1/4, 1/3, half, 2/3, and 3/4. You can also disable the snap and go anywhere. And you can also manipulate the arc like this. So I can have a perfect arc in between and also in the other direction. At any point, I can change my reference points. So I can put that here and put that here. It's really flexible. You can also reset to the start like this and tap your points again. And when I'm ready to draw my in-between, I can validate like this. And at any point, I can disable, enable the out of pegs. So here I will draw in between like this to manage my scale. And if I go back to the in between assist, it will keep the position of my out of pegs. So here I can see already my current drawing, but I can tap here, here to make another position. And you can make it with more than two drawings. So let's say here I will reset. I will add another in between here. And now I want to in between all of these. So I activate, I tap here. I activate it also, and I tap this, this, and this. And it will merge my three different onion skins that I can manipulate the same way. But now I have three different points that I can manipulate in space. That's for the in-between assist for one point in the edit mode. I will go back like this to make an out of pegs between these two. I go to my in-between assist, 2 points, edit mode. I put my 2 points. And now I have a few other options. So I still have the snap. Here it's not enabled. And here it's enabled to snap on 1/4, half, 1/3. Since you have 2 points now, you have to define which point will be the reference point for the movement. For example, here, I want to make an in-between between these poses. I go to my in-between assist, 2 points mode, edit mode, first point here, second point. Now for the second pose, I try to be at the same place, second point here. Now I can play with my position, half here with my arc, and I can switch point to control my rotation from that reference point here. For now, I'm in the small angle mode, so it goes to the shortest distance between point A and point B, but I can switch to big angle to take the longest distance between point A and point B. And here I have my perfect circle to work from. And that here with the small angle is also a perfect circle, but only a small part of it. At any point, I can adjust my reference points. That's how you can use in-between assist as a help in your breakdown and in-betweens. So let's have a more complex example now. With this character here from my short film Fragments of Sky, which you can see on YouTube, on Callipeg channel or on my channel. So I have Bastien here, my character, and I want to make an in-between between these two. And here it's in a cycle also. So I can double tap, edit the cycle, divide it from bottom to up to create an empty frame. I will reset my onion skin, activate it, so I can see the drawing before and after. So I go to my in-between assist, 2 points here with the edit. I go to the bottom of the shoe, top of the head. I try to go precisely here at the same place. And now I can also edit my points to be at the same place for the foot. I think here I go to that pivot point here, so I can drag it like this. Let's say I'm okay with that, so I can start my drawing, of course. And at any point, I can go back to my in-between assist, still have my onion skin in the same location. This time, I will make it 1 point, like this. So I tap here and here, and now I can slide to make an ease out here, for example, an ease in here, or even add a snap and make it to 3/4. And now I will be able to, for example, disable that onion skin here, validate, draw like that, and flip. So you can see here I have an ease in. It's not the correct color, no problem. And if I want to go back and let's say I want to add an in-between between those two fingers, I can either tap again on the edit and do, for example, this and this, and then snap it here on 1/4, for example, to have a really close position to the previous one. So I can draw like this to have a really subtle ease out. Or I could just reset everything here to go back to the initial location of my onion skin. And then I will tap, tap, and add my in-between, for example, at 3/4 here. So you can reset and start your in-between assist from scratch at each in-between, or tweak in-between assist from the same location and be very precise to go, for example, from the whole body to then only the head and then only the nose, only the eye, and really build your in-between like that. So that's the in-between assist available on iPad. And we truly believe that it will be a great help for your animation, and we can't wait to have your feedback on it. And it will be released on Android tablets as well in the future. Callipeg is available on iPads and Android tablets. It's a single purchase of 18 euros, no subscriptions. And Callipeg Mini is available on your iPhone App Store for 5 euros just once. Thanks a lot for watching. We hope that these new tools will help you in your animation process. And now start animating anywhere with Callipeg.